So, for the final part of sketching Tom Holland, our focus will be on the chin part, which is the lower part of lips. Then second will be neck and background of the Tom Holland, which is the portrait or the most of the edited part of the Avengers. And finally, a little bit part which is visible of Tom Holland's Spider-Man's costume. So for the first part, which is the chin part, there are two different parts which are going on right now on the chin. First is completely right hand side part where the light source is going directly. Then second part, which is the left hand side part of the chin or the also cheek part, where the light source is going from left hand side part. So of course the lower lip part of the face of Tom Holland is a little bit lighter as compared to upper part of the face. And the reason is that light source will not be I cannot say where the light source is placeable or the light source is coming from, but I can say that the light source is a little bit downward to upwards because the light part is on the lower part of the lips, but the darker part is on the upper part of the face where the forehead, darker part, nose parts is going on. So you have to keep on focusing where the light source is going. So after that, the background is also a little bit darker in some places and lighter in some places. So I have used graphite powder for making backgrounds. You can also use a cross hatching method and then blend it using a blending stump, but I have used graphite powder because the background of the Tom Holland's portrait that I am using or the reference picture that I am using, the background looks too flat and looks seamless. Or what I mean about seamless is that's completely flat. There are no grains, there are no details are going on the backgrounds. So I have used graphite powder using a makeup brush so that I apply more and more flat look to it. If just keep on focusing, what I'm saying right now is that if you want a flat look on face, on background or any other things, I will recommend that you use makeup brush or any paint brush and powders like charcoal powder or graphite powder. It will help you give you a flat or completely beautiful blushy look. And if you want to give more and more details like hyper realistic sketches, don't use charcoal powders or any other powders in any other it will give you a completely flat look. If you are using a charcoal or graphite powder for the base layer, it is completely okay. But if you are making or using a charcoal or graphite powder for a first layer or second layer for the details like skin texture, like any other portrait parts like hairs, neck or any other parts, I am not recommending that. If you are using for a base layer, it is okay, because for the base layer we always use 2B pencil or 3B pencil. So instead of using a 3B pencil and cross hatching and any other details things or any other techniques for base layer, just use charcoal powder and makeup brush and use a graphite powder also. That is also recommendable, but I personally use hatching method for the base layers. But I have used powder for the background because it is completely flat. Now for the parts of the skin texture on the neck and the lower part of the chin and the cheek part, I didn't see any of the details there. Like the upper part of the forehead, there were straight linings, so many details like straight cell linings or any skin texture were visible on the full portrait. But the lower part of the face, there are no visible outlines or no visible skin texture. So I have zoomed out my picture as much as I can, but I didn't see any of the details. So I have directly gone for a completely flat look, but little bit detailed, but not completely flat. So if you are having a portrait or commission artwork or any other portrait that you are making, if you don't see details like skin texture or any other things, just don't make those details on your sketch also. Like if you will apply skin texture on the portrait and if you don't see those details on the portrait, that reference picture that you are using, it will give you a completely horrible look, and you don't want that, right? If you will make 300-400 sketches, you will see the skin textures, directions and any other portraits and details things. After that, you can apply skin texture and details on your sketches also. But before that, I don't recommend making those skin texture if you don't see skin texture. Now For the neck part, there is a part left hand side completely black part. So for that, use 6B pencil. But before that, just use base layer as a 6B or 5B pencil. Then go for directly darker parts, as the complete face is of 2B pencil. So first layer will be of 2B pencil, base layer of 2B pencil, and then first layer will be darker parts, because the costume of Spider-Man is blending with the neck part. So you have to make it look more beautiful and blended it easily using a costume. So for making the costume part, there are too many details. So if you want to apply more and more details to your sketches, you have to use your pencils, more sharpened pencils. So for that, you have to sharpen your pencil as much as you can. And the problem with graphite pencil is that after 2 or 5 strokes, or max to max 10 to 15 strokes, it looks a little bit flat, and it will give you a complete flat look. And the problem with costumes, ornaments, or any other things that your portrait or your reference picture is wearing, their edges are a little bit sharpened as compared to any other. Like, face is never sharp, hairs are never sharp, but the skin texture is a little bit sharper, but not complete sharp also. But ornaments or any other thing that your portrait is wearing or the reference picture is wearing will give you a sharpened look. So for that, use mechanical pencil, or you can also use a sharpened pencil. And if you don't know how to sharp your portrait pencils, like, there are different type of pencils usage. Like, if you are making a scenery or any other portraits or any other things, like you are directly going for sketching or any other things, you don't have to sharpen your pencil as much as you can or you want. But if you are going for realistic sketches or hyper realistic sketches, you have to sharpen your pencils so that you can apply more and more details. The more and more details you will apply to your sketches, it will look more realistic and more hyper realistic. So for that, sharpen your pencil as much as you can. Like, the costume of Spider-Man is looking straight or edges, so I have sharpened my pencils as much as I can. So if you don't know how to sharpen your pencils for sketching of portraits, just comment down below. I will make another portrait for you. So after making those portraits look more beautiful, the final part is that have patience. And the patience, what I mean about saying patience, is that after applying more and more details to your sketches, it will be a time consuming thing. It will not give you a particular portrait and complete portrait in just 1 or 2 hours. It will take your time. So give time to your sketches. It will look more and more.
So that was all for this tutorial. If you have learned something from this video, subscribe and drop a like. Comment down your question and queries regarding this tutorial. Meanwhile, take care of your loved ones too. Have an artistic day. Tattoos.